somebody like, it's a first day in this structure of faith that we will have a complete video lesson. If we are lucky. But so far we don't know if we are lucky. But hopefully this will be the day. So the full video conference. For those of you on one side who can write friends literally in Alpine to becoming the result of this habit to look in living in the next time. Okay? Then you know that we are at least through the first 7 parts. So before you leave today, you have been to 7. Is that what you mean? I mean, it's the middle of the week. There is no part in your future. So now we know that we know something that is worth writing 7 chapters about. Can you keep that? We talk about standard model, terms of play, mobile employee. Hopefully, before we get it. We also start to talk about type culture. But first of all, let's start with the standard model. Right? And since this was the last part of the same age, we do everything we have to do with the type. So this time we will do both a slide version and the standard classical. And since technology has developed, it has, we can complete the first 9 classic words to the others. This is now the standard model. What is specific to this standard model? For those of you who can read English, it is a very special solution, the standard model, where there is no code. Where is the no code? And now you ask for French mathematicians. Where is the no code? Yeah. So the demand equals the production for both goods. This would be a very special method of, let's say, consumption thinking. And since there are so many countries, could you mean that if that special method that might have happened, then it was only two, and one was other, and the other was different. But now, this is not a very public thing. So this is the start. The standard model would then be, let's say, it's a domestic solution system. We do not a domestic code. So what we will do now, in practice, is to why is code beneficial? Is that a fair deal? Okay. Good. Yeah. So how do we do it? The classic version means an income. When we look to the left of the two groups of feet, why is the code in the snap? So, there is my long stick finger. Since I stopped using the blue thing really long, because it comes from the center. So, this is productive. Given by the answer by the line, this is the consumption. So therefore, production is different from consumption. Point one. So can we see that? If you want to count it, just move a few pages backwards. And I will say stop where you are there. It's in the snippet of the paper if you want and you got a copy. But this is the secret that they tell the other students that this is not here and that. If you move the paper, a little bit more, a little bit more, you can see those persons, you know, the top of the business, you don't see it. Yes? Three pages, four pages, eight pages, yes! Is it? That it is. Okay. So do not take all of the figures that you have a copy. That's what I'm saying. So if you want to paint a drawing, do it as an artist and sell it in the street for, let's say, 200 Norwegian kroner. That is about the price of the party gift that you would have to raise it. So in this case, could this point and consumption differ? What are the important? There are two possibilities. One is one, the other one is one. What good are the important? This one or that one? I promise that we should not talk all the time about food and care. So let's say these are tasks, and this is a project. So what are the important in this case? We produce less of this year, don't we? We produce more of this year than we consume. So then, this is not normally good. So these are cars, we import cars. So we use more cars than we produce. Yes, okay? So then you know this. What are the exports in the other? So far, so good. Why do we pay this import rate? Because we produce here, we consume here. How do we pay for it? By export. And here is what we consume, here is what we produce. Is the relative price of about one? Now you have to have a very good view. You have, let's say, what we call a distance. Okay. But obviously, that is the distance to production and the good. The export, this is the production of the good import. That is more than this. Isn't it? Because this is less than this, isn't it? So for those of you who want to put your lines now already, you see that the amount that you import is bigger than what you export. How do you explain that? Very expensive. Why do you think that if you export more expensive goods, then you have to export less to pay for more money? And that explains why there are so many German cars in Europe. Because what they sell to you is relatively more expensive. You need more of it than you do. I think the question in Norway is about the 2% of what you produce in PC. How much is left for export? About 98%. What about Germany? Do they export 98% of their cars? Probably there are too many German cars in Germany to do 90%. So when the prices for export is high, then we need to produce less to pay for that. That is a theory that we learned in chapter 2, 3, 6, and 5. So this was the third version of chapter 2, 3, 6, and 5. Okay? Do you remember chapter 3? Okay, if you have a time, let's say tomorrow night, it is simply that in this case, more export needs to pay for much more income. Simply because it's not. So what, number one, okay? How do Germany look like? No, that was a paper. You already got the paper with the book. How is this Germany? So this is the two countries. What one country imports, the other one exports. But as I said, even though German cars are expensive, the drive is even more expensive. So we get the money. And that is something why the Netherlands are not producing many cars in the country. If I look at you and ask your mother to send you an email, what was the length of the Dutch cup that once drove through Norway in months every month? A small, nice, tidy cup. It looked like a Ford engine. Most of you would see in a helicopter at the same version. This was the Dutch version. Very small, nice, tiny car. Not as small as the dark diesel one. Very cheap, very nice. So, the custom car production was in Germany and New York. You know that. What was the brand of the two diesel cars that had been produced? What is the difference between coal and coke? Yes, that coal goes on biodiesel. You never produce a petrol diesel car because you haven't gotten petrol. And now when they come, you do that. So this is the standard model of one country export for the other import. And then it must be like this. Well, so far so good. No one wants to do the trade yet. What happens if terms of trade change? This is the most critical question this afternoon. Why do you pay for pay pay when you're done? It changes the relative supply of it and the relative demand in this country for the pay because relative prices change. So far, so good. What trade pays is relative to the relative demand of the people. Then the relative prices change. And we will show it later. And this was just the case of what is coming in. We call it a piece of the book. So this was today's piece. So now we have shown that terms of trade influence trade and changes from production. Consumption equality without trade to different things. And for those of you who remember chapter 2, 3, 4, and 5, what is the effect of trade? Disclaiming that of country. Export is most important part of import because we call it indirect production. So it is specialized in our export production. Price increases the demand. We reduce the production domestically of the imported goods. And then imported goods are added in the production. So one, the more values are added. Two, we get more products added. Because it's not. And three, it's not. Why do the other country do vice versa? Because relative prices changes, opposite direction. So the same input is the new output. Because they need indirect production of oil exported goods, their input. And they get it from half the price. So if you turn something, I see in my 3 months, a very short reason that I remember that so, the idea with trade is very simple. You have a certain amount of resources. You can use it for production. If you produce one part within the basic carbon level, you get less out of the resources. Why do we do it? It's simply because the relative price in return for domestic is what is making the most profit. And so we but when you open up the when it's relative price is expensive, so we increase our value by exporting some amount of production. This facility pays money. So, what happens domestically again? If the price doubles, what about demand? The domestic demand, if the price drops, what happens to the market prices left? Yes, so what we actually do is by taking the prices domestic consumption, if we need to have those prices, that leaves half of it for so we can export. So half of the production that we use to consume is now so expensive that it's left for other countries to pay for. Where are they? In fact, why do they buy it from us? Because they get it from us to cost. Why don't we use it domestically? Because we can double it. So this is terrible, different, probably not too difficult microeconomic theory. So prices go up, domestically, consumption is reduced, now need an amount for export, which we export. Why on earth do we export? That is in fact intended to be from the price of the export. Why do we export? Okay, so what we do is simply reduce consumption of the good that we want to export, rather than increase the income. Then we sell it to foreign, but they pay for it. They leave us money that we can use to buy imported goods. Why do we not produce on the front? Simply because it's double price. So this is the stuff that you can buy in goods and domestic produced goods. 100 Norwegian for the imported, 400 for goods, 100 for the imported. So would we buy it for 200 because it's produced in Norway, or would we buy it for 100? Even though it's probably in the money. And then say, yes, I'm buying it for them. Thank you. That is the value of it. Except, pays for the input, increases our indirect production. We can consume more. And we can do it with the money we already have. So that is, in fact, the standard way. So then it sounds simple enough. But when I look at you and think that not all of you have read very thoroughly in chapter 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it might be a little difficult, but you sooner or later realize that. It simply places prices, relative prices. That places our consumption pattern, not production pattern, so we open up by reducing the domestic use of the export rate. I would tell the very very wealthy Germans who pay extra for this. This money we need to pay for our import. Why do we import it? It's simply because it's much cheaper to import than to import. That is in fact something that is simpler number than what they did a week ago, or even 2 weeks ago, when things are moving in the right direction. It is more difficult now than it did yesterday, and I'm not saying yesterday, but the day before. able to connect. If that is the kind of way, we open up the case, that is the demand for this and supply it, and it breaks the link between consumption and production. We can produce more than we consume, simply because there is someone out there, very wealthy Germans, who are willing to pay for this export, and we earn more money. I think we earn more money because of that. So one day, we even will buy the most expensive Italian cars, but that will be in fact 16 or 17. Are there any expensive French cars? Not compared to the UK or the Europe. Some of us like to go to work. If you have food, you have food. I think there are only certain reasons for four, at least it has to be some of the food. But there are some of that. So if you want to see them, look up on YouTube and look up early some food. You can see very nice form, very nice inside, and very ergonomic, but that is not a problem. It moves in 60 kilometers per hour. And who needs aerodynamic design if you need to? You can even cycle a section if you are both of them in the design. So, this is the effect of taste. It makes it cheaper to buy what you need instead of producing it. And it makes it more expensive to use our exporting goods. So, unlucky you poor guys, you cannot afford our Norwegian export. If you buy Italian imports. So therefore, there is no Norwegian wine. Because most of it is produced in France, in Italy, not so much in the Netherlands, in Australia. So the first question we have 15 centimeters of who will be the biggest wine exporter? In the world. Is it China? Is it Spain? Is it France? Is it Italy? Or is it Australia? I'll give you five options. I think it's an answer, but not probably in life because the most expensive in the world is flowing to Japan on the 25th or 25th of the and it's produced very poorly. So there are some very expensive. But not that it will be the whole value because it will take you a lot. But selling is a matter. Okay? 20 minutes to think it over. You leave that be as I come up with consensus. So you have to do five questions. This is from the it's a simple model explaining that consumption and production can be split. The reason why it's split is simply because price is expensive and makes it more profitable to export and, let's say, less costly to import because of the value. So, in fact, we could pass up our cookies to finish the world and celebrate. The Norwegian food cost something basically yesterday because we were both prices, both in the month. So, every week. Yeah, so that is it. We come back to it later. So, once we like to grow, don't worry. We come back to it. But the standard model is very easily to gain some profit. And the gain is simply higher value for your resources, and then you can adopt to a higher indifference level, or what we call in standard lighting, can you call it on a higher value. And I would like to thank the one of you who corrected the other one. When you pay for the work, okay, then we will have a different thing. So, it is a nice word there. When do we take comparative advantage? What happens she said, that is why more expensive than Spanish food. Spanish food is probably more expensive than Spanish food. But that doesn't matter. If they think it is because they have comparison, you can compare it to compare, and they can be eat two different things. Why not? So whatever model you would like to present in the next part, let's say, on the main menu of the same, if there is a couple that you want to present to do the best. Whatever you think of, any trade you take, all models contain the one and the striking fact. Trade is beneficial. But we trade because of comparison. So we have to compare to comparison. One thing you have to remember is to have two products, one from the other country, and a customer. So two goods, two countries produce them because of comparison. If somebody stops you, let's say, stop in the center, and you ask, what will your cost of bread? And listen to you say, do you know about comparative advantage? And then you say, yes, I can then go to the answer, because that is the thing to speak. Because then you can get to the thing. So comparative simply means to compare the two countries. And one expert is very important. And in two. So that is hopefully the concept. Because I think I got an email from the Navy saying, now it's doing it better than it did the last, the first condition. Is that correct? Or is not? But we're going to find out after the contest with the company that I'm in. Science of faith simply is the relative crisis of the condition. Why do we call it terms of faith? Because one is imported, the other one is exported. So what we compare is simply the prices of the two goods because they lead to a trade, and that trade is the price of trading export and import. Okay? And if you can see that through the glasses, then we take the next one. Both countries, trade and import, they have a value of export that is high. And the cost of import is lower than producing the export. So both do, simply because it's more than export, cost of them, they pay less for import, cost of them, and both will be the same. What is confusing and confusing is that these two countries do not produce for the same cost of home. So the price of home is different than this. So if you remember the problem, I mean, the model, it simply shows that the relative prices in the current production of the country is a 2 to 1 to 1. While a home is a 1 to a half. So therefore, this case is to be a 1 to 1. So instead of having 2, you get import and pay the 1. Instead of importing in the other country, you pay the price of 2 to get it back to any paper. So both countries, both countries are relative prices, and that is the case. Then I see a nod, because now you want to go on. Because of the economy. So, both countries have more value for the export, and they can buy the import for a lower price. So, therefore, it is difficult to trade. Because they have more money to buy from, they can buy more goods by importing, but that is not the case. So, all you have to remember is that if a way to produce two goods. It can be a home or a shop. If it's exported, the price has changed in the direction called faith, that it increases the value. Okay? Export of home is import of work. The brothers got the war because of the terms of faith. If they didn't support the price, if they had done this themselves, it would have cost them death. And you got the idea, then you do that import consumption. Okay, now the German Nordic Fund for Mathematicians has checked it up on the internet, and the answer is that it's not Spanish money. No, it's not Italian money. So this is the trade theory in short. Prices, relative prices, benefit both countries and improve the welfare. But one, so all we have to remember is three things. It places relative prices, it benefits both countries, and it benefits the consumers in both countries because they can adapt to the market. This sounds like a medal ceremony at the Olympics. Number three, it improves the welfare of the consumption. So it's a flower to the consumer. It increases the benefit for each country. That's the power of the country. But who will be the winner? So we have improved the country's welfare, each individual's welfare, and we have more value of the power of the country. And that is the great thing. It will be handed over by the female secretary of the export community in southern Berlin. They have never been this far. But the reason why we go to Berlin is to think of girls. The female biotech women work for the girls. So, this is a simple comparative advantages, benefits to the country and the consumer. And it gets more out of the bank than it is. That should be easy. Okay? Not too bad. Okay, could have been worse. Okay, can you do that? So the funding model looks like this. There is no trade in DC. Why is there no trade in DC? Yes. What happens if the trade pool has trade changes? Because we now no longer consume what we produce. In fact, we import products. So in DC, what in DC, the terms of trade has shifted, so we produce in Q1 and consume in Q1. It's like a little bit comforting that it says production is Q1, then demand is Q1. So there are a lot of these, there are a lot of things that they are linked together. Why is there not a Q3? This is for both of you, and still are the waiter. Why is there not a Q3? I still believe that the French mathematicians could help us. Why is there not a Q3? The B3 equals Q3. I think it's messy already. Truman might have thought when he wrote this book and said, okay, now there are so many letters in it. So I write in writing that Q3 is D3 and I'm going to be in figure because then there is no trade. And this is a book about trade theory. Why should we mess it up? And I think your mother sent me an email and said, that was right for me. Because it's a mess with all those letters. So, there are two types for trade. The reason why we trade 2-1, 2-1. And I think this point of faith will be called WW1. And now comes a very tricky question to me. Why do we call it WW1? I think he's a fox. That's it. In French, I'm not sure. Why do we call it WW1? This is for those of you who can remember 8 days back. Money. Even if I use a gun point, this is viable. I can see 5 feet. Also, why do we call it lead? So if my wife says, you are probably hit by an Alzheimer's, I say, don't worry, I have seen that Alzheimer's is abusing it. You need them for value. It's easy value. It gives you the same value for the resource for everything. So every time you do a DVD, it's not a point problem because that's in value. It simply means a value. So the value line here shows us that this is the price, relative price of it, it could be equal to one. It is consumed in D1. So since Q1 is less than D1, food is. Now I tell you, you even don't remember 30 minutes. If Q1 is less than D1, food is less. And then for all the others, if Q1 if Q1 is bigger than D1, then the clothes is very good. And it's so impressive. So that is just for the simple stated very straight. The established trade relations. What cases? That cases where the equal value line slope, which is the relative price. Okay. What has happened here? What has happened? Let's start with the relative prices. What has happened to the relative prices from D1 to D2? So, the export value has gone up. That's not how you call it. So, then there is the production of it. This is what we export. We export less. That means that the export prices have gone up. So, the reason why we shift from Q1 to Q2 is that the relative prices have gone up and the value of our export has gone up. It's steeper. Okay? Why do we need an export so much? And surprise, surprise, we can even import more than this. That sounds a little bit unfair. But this one is going to be unfair. That is the most important. Okay? So that is the fundamental. Then we have to speed it up a little bit and say, we split production from consumption. Consumption is decided by relative prices. If they change, we change our consumption. We also change our production, and that influences trade too. The production function has he cannot follow the script, he can choose love. So this is the production function. It places itself. Because maybe relative weights will go up, so there are more labels possible, so you can produce more because you did more and faster. So this influences production function. But in this standard here, the best way is to get this function. You see it here, and you see it here. Yeah. So what has happened is that in fact it works like this, the code is between maybe you see the difference. Now it's just before it breaks, then it's code selection, then it places mid. So it gets access to more effects, it can produce more, and probably it produce more than this. So those of you, remember the specific model or the vector alien model? None of you have had nightmares so far. Because when I say vector alien, somebody will have later. Can you have all murdered vector alien? But since none of you do, so far, I've not had so this is what it is about. Then the code source ends up with all that will be a function of the influence of production. And that is history when it decides to take it. So don't worry about the theory behind it. In the standard model, this is given by the production. Okay? So it need not be difficult. But since you are in Norway, you were looking for steel because you were expecting snow in the street. About loads of a meter or two. Every day you went out, you had to move in this steep snow. And obviously, you had the bath as well. Now we have destroyed your home. I'm sorry for that. And probably you can follow the theory. So, you normally use two. Or selection, but factor could be different. But in this additional model, it's factor or it's labor and value. Later it will be technology. The technology might be factor. But that is a different thing. Don't worry about that. Just remember this in our study. It will only be the same thing. But if you can live with all the different things, don't think of it as the result of your original task, because then I think you will think another lesson from the very simple. Okay? But this is the standard one. Demand is B, consumption is C, and B is the benefit of it, and A is if you can reproduce it sometime then not. Okay? So, point is indirect, import is indirect production. It places the production in front of it. It is something equation. And I think I can promise you, this is the only equation you will see in this text. Would that be a little bit comforting before we take a break? There will be one equation. It looks like this. The B stands for the value, and the value of the consumption is the value of the production. That is the maximum production of each good to F. If you rearrange it, you will find it. And you will see that the slope is the relative price. And in addition, this is also rearranged. And it says, the value of what we export, if we export growth, is the value of what we import, if we import food. Because we do not use all of it. of it, and you do not produce all of it. So this is the equation. You can find the vital information there. You can only know the slope of it. The value of the export is equal to the value of the import. So there is nothing in this world but so good that you cannot put into this simple equation. So think of that when you're ranking the next math course. In this course, it's only one equation you need to explain to your family. Even when you are so tired in the middle of a very selection, could be explained. Thank you. So this is the only one. You need not have nightmares, because if you look at those mathematicians, they have problems looking forward to much more complicated mathematics of your mathematics. So this says that the value of four is the value of eight in both countries. Why in both countries? Yeah, so one country import, the other one export. If the value of another country import is equal to the export, you have to discard it to your money from the other. So what value of four is what we import. The value of what they export is the value of what they import. The value of what we import, not export, is equal to what our export. So it's balance. So this is the only place on earth where there is balance. All three. Unlike if you are a student and you break it up, all of that. But then you are all students and come up with this stuff. No one but you will get this. It's a very simple equation, it's plain terms, everything. It's like going to the doctor. And you say, oh, I think I've got a cold. And you say, okay, take the pill here. And then you come back a week later and say, I have a very problematic injury in my leg. Okay, take the pill. It's so painful, so very important. Or if you speed step, or bother, go to bed, no. There's a lot of injury on your face. So this is the simplest place on earth that it can be. There's this one equation, it can't explain the heaven. Okay? So then we need, should we say, 30 minutes break? So we can see that it should be 15:19. No, 15 something. 19 your network, 10 to the network. And there is a case for those of you who want to celebrate that this course is very simple, it's only one equation, they celebrate it.